Welcome back to My Time to Fly. Today we're going to talk about high wing versus low wing airplanes and my opinion of why I chose what I did. If you like general aviation videos, certainly if you like flying videos, I invite you to click that subscribe button. We're going to have a lot of fun on this channel and I want you along for the journey. A little bit of background about me. I did all my training in high wing airplanes. I flew in 150s and 152s and then subsequently logged about 100 hours in 172s. I really had zero low wing time. And then a few months ago, a friend of mine reached out and asked to share some time in a Piper Warrior he was flying. Again, I had no experience flying in a Piper, but after a couple hours, I thought, hey, maybe there's something here. Maybe there's something to this low wing deal. So here's my personal pros and cons list. I'm sure that I've left plenty of things off this list. So take a minute and add to it in the comments below. Let's make this video really useful for anybody who's trying to decide. Just put your pros and cons down there and we'll have a good commentary. With that said, let's jump into the list. So I've broken it down into six categories, each with a different level of importance for different folks. The first category is accessibility. So really the ability to get in and out of the airplane. For low wing airplanes, I really don't have many pros, except maybe it would be easier to get out of one in the event of a water landing, where the wings would potentially keep you above the water for a little while. There are quite a few cons, I guess, in my opinion, about accessibility. Most low wing airplanes only have one door, so that can be a challenge to load and unload passengers, especially as the pilot typically has to be in the plane first. You also have to go up onto the wing and then typically back down into the cabin. So it is just a lot of ups and downs. And actually the gentleman I bought my Mooney from sold it primarily because of the struggle of getting in and out. On high wing, so Cessnas will say, there's typically two doors, and it's just overall easier to get in and out. The pilot can help people get in and out of the airplane, and he can be the last to get in, and that makes things a little bit easier. You also typically only have to step up into the plane, and just overall, I think it's an easier experience. The second one is heat, so how warm it is in the cabin. I think this is commonly discussed. You know, from my experience, I will say that low wing airplanes, and I've only flown in a few, but low wing airplanes are just a little bit warmer. Often there's less shade. You get some reflection, or you can get some reflection from the wings. And you certainly don't have two big shades in high wings hanging over you like you would in a high wing. You also don't have windows that fully open most of the time. So during ground operations, you have to leave one door open or use the puny little window on the pilot side to get a little bit of air. With high wing airplanes, there's typically better venting. So the vents, especially up at the top, the header, they really can pump a lot of air onto you when you get warm. Third on my list is fuel. So a low wing airplane will be much easier to put fuel in, check fuel levels, maybe a little bit more challenging to sump fuel, but certainly overall easier on fuel. Now there are cons to the low wing's fuel system. They typically are more complicated. Almost all the time they include electric fuel pump along with a mechanical fuel pump. And rather than having the common both selector like a Cessna would, you have to manage your fuel left and right. Now some may view this as a con. For me, it's allowed me to become more proficient with flight planning. So although it is a little bit of extra work, I actually am starting to prefer having to run off one tank at a time. So overall, I would say it's a wash. It's a little bit more difficult to put fuel in a high wing. It's a little bit easier to sump fuel from a high wing. The fuel system on a low wing is typically a little bit more complicated. So I think that the pros and cons pretty much level out there. Next on the list, we'll talk about visibility. I will say, in a low-wing airplane, it is easier to see the horizon. And I feel overall visibility is a little bit better, even though you can't see through the wing and see the ground. Of course, in a high wing, you get better views of the ground. And one thing that I really like is that you can see the wheels. That is one thing I miss. So in the Mooney that I fly now, especially being a retract, although I know the gear is down and I go through the checks, you can't visually see them. Now, I know some planes have mirrors installed which make it easier to see or you able to see the wheels. But in general, it is a great feeling to look out and see your inflated tire in a high wing airplane. But overall, I have to give the visibility nod to the low wing. I just think you can see overall better. Next, we'll talk about cleaning. I think it's a little bit easier to clean a low wing airplane, especially easier to clean the top of the wing. They both are no fun to clean the bottom surfaces, laying on a crawler and wheeling yourself around. But it's my overall opinion that it's much easier to clean a low wing if you're just trying to clean the leading edges and the windshield after a flight. It just takes a little bit less time. You don't have to get a ladder out. Anybody, my six-year-old could clean the front edges of my plane. She's tall enough. So I give the nod to the low wing in that case. Last on my list is ground clearance. It is certainly nice to have a high wing if you're in situations where you may have high snow banks, off airport landings, high berms, or if you like to store a few extra things in your hangar. The low wing is prohibitive to putting many extra things in your hangar, where a high wing will allow you to park a car, a trailer, a boat underneath the wing. Now, not all airports allow that to happen, but in many cases, people store some extra things in their hangar, and a high wing does make that a little bit easier. Now, if you're flying out of normal paved runways and nice climates, the ground clearance may not be an issue. But if you like landing on grass strips or short field, soft field, or a little bit of unmanicured, unprepared airstrips, the low wing may not be a great option for you. So there's my list. I hope you enjoyed it, and again, I hope you add some to the list in the comments below. Now, one thing I didn't talk about was flight characteristics, and I didn't get into flight characteristics because, let's be honest, although there may be some inherent differences between high and low wing, the specific plane you fly has a much bigger impact. Let's not compare my Mooney to a Carbon Cub and say that they fly different because they are high wing or low wing. Now, that's okay. You can leave a comment below regarding if you believe there are flight characteristics that are just inherently different, like how much the plane tends to float. But I thought that was just a bit of a too big of a topic to dive into. At the end of the day, my opinion is it doesn't matter what you fly. I like them both. I love my low wing Mooney right now. If I found a great deal on a 182, I'd probably have to have that as well. They each have their own pros and cons. If you're a flight student who's just getting started, I'd really invite you to fly them both. Make your own opinion. Decide what you like. You might like them both, and just understand that there are differences, and each can be used for a different mission. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter what you fly. Just get out and find some time to fly. Thanks again for being here. We'll see you guys in the next video.